Hi, we're t.A.T.u.
You're watching
Urban.ro.
How do you feel today? How are you?
Oh, we're great. A little tired though.
And you?
Fine. Yeah, I have surgery, vocal cords, but right now it's like I need a time a little bit. I'm fine. I'm okay. Thank you.
Last night you performed after a long time together for Voice of Romania. How was that? How did it feel?
When we have rehearsal, I start to cry. It's like my emotion. I'm just, you know, remember everything. Vanya, me and Lena, like how we just, you know.
Tied together.
Yes, and like long time ago. It's good.
For you, how was it?
I would agree with Julia. It felt really natural, you know, after all these years. I mean, I would still think we would need to rehearse a little more, and if we are going to be on stage together again, with every single time, it's going to get better and better. But yesterday was a start.
200 kilometers in the wrong lane. It's the 10th anniversary. How does it feel like? How do you remember? How was it like recording the album?
Oh my god, long time ago. Yeah, I remember. I was screaming to lose my voice. So, but it's good. It's our first big walk. So it's like very exciting. Anniversary.
Well, for me, it's kind of strange that it is a 10-year anniversary of our album and we are still so young. And we still have the whole life in front of us.
You were 15 when you started?
Yeah, 14. Yeah. So, I mean, it really feels cool to be very young and still have a lot of stuff in the future. But to have a 10-year anniversary album, which was worldwide and very successful.
When you recorded it in the studio, did you expect it to be that big, that successful, that?
Studio, think about like big.
Yeah, how big it will become.
We just try to do something new, just lesbian stuff, you know, kissing, and just okay, everything everywhere, just all the things you said. So it's good for us, and just a surprise for us, and just oh, Lena, look at this.
Hold on. How did it feel for you?
It was absolutely unexpected, I think, for every single person who was working with us.
Two teenagers, really talented two teenagers, who were just working in the studio, and all of a sudden, all the world attention was on you, from the US to Japan to everywhere.
It was exactly like the next day we became famous, and then it spread all over the world. It was really cool, but it was so unexpected. I think for a long time I couldn't even believe that it is actually happening to me, and I mean to us. Because it was like a fairy tale, like dream came true. It was a dream come true.
About dreams, I was wondering about that. When you were kids, did you dream about it? Did you dream about being on stage, about performing in front of thousands and thousands of people and singing? Was that your dream when you were a kid?
Yeah, I don't like to dream. So it's like I live like today and right now. So I like this, and I'm just when I was a little girl, I want to be singer, but it's not dream. I like this, and I do it like you know, like I wake up and brush my teeth. So it's like it's my life.
For you?
It was my dream, and I was always, you know, laying there and trying to imagine myself on a big stage playing. But I never ever could think that it might actually happen to me. So that was like a miracle.
Do you think that it is important to have your family support when you're starting off your career? Did that happen for you? Did you have your family support?
Yeah, we did have a family support, and it is actually very important because family always stands by your side, and no matter what, they are there for you in every single situation. But our families are really tolerant, and they were supporting us every single moment of our lives.
And they stayed by you. Even though with all the controversial things that you've done in the past, right? Why do you think your fans stay so loyal? Do you have like a lot of loyal fans that are still supporting you right now? Why do you think that they still love you that much? And they...
Well, a lot of people think that we changed their lives, and I think that it is true because we did. We helped them to feel free and not alone in this world. And of course, lately it was something different from TATU, like both of us were working on our solo projects, but they are waiting for both of our stuff and for TATU songs, and they're still there. I think they will always be there. And this is amazing. I mean, our fans are probably the best fans in the world. For us.
You think that because you had like a really strong message within your lyrics, and you are really honest with your lyrics? That's why?
It's not only a message, it's like feelings and inside us. And they maybe feel us and feel our music, our inside world.
My favorite song that you sang is 30 Minutes. Mm. How did that song came along? I'm really curious about it.
It's hard to say because a bunch of songs came along like in a pretty same time, and it was written by Sergei Galoyan, the writer of All the Things She Said and Not Gonna Get Us and a lot of other songs. So it was just a beautiful ballad, and it was kind of a development of a relationship, because if you're gonna go through all our videos we had, All the Things She Said, Not Gonna Get Us, then 30 Minutes, it's like a telling story. One goes into another one, blending together. So that was a part of the story, a big story we were telling to the world.